Craig James from Masculinity by Design here. Find me on Twitter at Masculine Design. That's at Masculine Design on Twitter. So I've been thinking a lot lately about what it is that makes certain men more successful than others. What is it that keeps them going? How is it that they're able to ascend to such extreme heights in their career or in their family lives? How is it that they're spurred on, that they seem to have so much energy and they can keep going regardless of all of the distractions or people who are trying to pull them down, different adversity that they might be experiencing as they ascend on their journey through life and in their careers? And certainly hard work plays a big aspect in that. You have to work hard to achieve anything in life that's worth achieving, certainly. But there are people, and this describes me at certain points in time, even lately in my life, they just seem to attack whatever goals, whatever purpose they have with such an intensity and limitless energy. It's almost supernatural. They don't slow down. They don't let challenges or obstacles get the better of them. They keep plowing through. They keep ascending. They keep growing. They keep progressing in whatever it is they're achieving to aspire towards. And as I've thought about this, I've noticed that there's a common denominator that these people all have. Now, it's a common denominator that can be used very destructively and is used very destructively by a lot of people, especially men. But when harnessed the right way, it can be extremely powerful towards helping us to continue to improve in our lives. And what that common denominator is having these people, they have a chip on their shoulder. They're pissed off for success is kind of the way I like to think about it. They're out to prove something. They're out to prove to themselves that they can do something that maybe they previously wouldn't have thought they could do before. They're out to prove to other people, people in their lives, people around them that maybe live in mediocrity and who think that whatever it is that they're trying to achieve is impossible or beyond their skill set or their abilities to achieve. And so they're out to prove them wrong. They're pissed off. They're pissed off for success. It's not a looking outward and trying to attack or bring other people down kind of pissed off. It's a pissed off like, you know, I'm going to show you. You say I can't do something? Okay, well, I'll show you I can do something. And there's a confidence to that is really powerful, and it helps some of the most successful people around us to achieve the things that they've achieved, and we can take advantage of that for ourselves as well. Growing up, I spent a lot of time around people who had the wrong kind of chips on their shoulders. These were guys, young men, who were angry at the world. They you know, blamed everything and everybody else for everything that they didn't have or the things that they wish they could achieve but weren't achieving. And so their goal in life was destructive. It was to bring other people down. It was to attack the people who they felt were responsible for what they didn't have in life. And whenever you carry that view, it is extremely toxic. It takes away the energy that you should and could be using toward trying to find out what it is in your life that's keeping you from advancing, from reaching the levels you want to reach, from achieving what you want to achieve. It saps that energy because you're focusing all of your energy on attacking other people who have what you don't have, or who have what you want to have, or who you think are keeping you from getting what you want in life. There's absolutely no value in this. We're trying to attack something in that case that's outside of our control. It's sapping our energy. It's providing nothing in terms of value to our lives when we could be looking inward, using that chip on our shoulder to want more, to prove others wrong, to prove to ourselves that we can do better. Use that energy to attack the things in our life inwardly that we need to be doing in order to progress as an individual, as a man, to unlock the potential that we've been created to have. It's interesting to see, you know, these people that have these chips on their shoulders toward the world around them. You know, they're so busy attacking all these people around them and in the world that you know, they don't even notice. You know, it's they're being eaten up from the inside out. They're hurting. You know, they're hurting themselves. They're draining their positive energy that could be used for good and using it for destructive purposes. Meanwhile, the people they're outwardly attacking or that they have this anger against, most of the time have no idea or could care less. They're continuing to go about their lives. They're living their life as a man. They're pursuing their goals. They're having an impact on the world. And it's like these people who have this negative chip on their shoulder They're like a person drinking poison and expecting it to hurt somebody else. It defies logic. Now, those who have the right chip on their shoulder, a positive chip on their shoulder, they focus on the things that are inside of their control. They don't focus on the things outside of their control, blame something or somebody else for whatever they don't have or something they think they deserve. Nobody owes them anything. People who have a positive chip on their shoulder, they look inward to the things that are inside of their control to see what they can do to take control of their situation. If there are undesirable circumstances in their life, what can they do to change them? Maybe it's, you know, they want to climb the corporate ladder, so they need to get a college degree. Maybe they need to take some special technical training in order to advance in their job. Just whatever it might be that they see that's keeping them back. Maybe they have a problem with alcohol or drug addiction, and that's keeping them from doing the things in life that they really desire to do, and so they get treatment for that. Whatever it is, it's looking inward. It's not looking outward. It's seeing what is in their control, which is what masculine men do. They take responsibility for their actions and their choices, and when they see corrective action that needs to take place, they take it. They take the steps that need to be taken in order to realign themselves with the virtuous, responsible calling that they have, one where they're responsible for their actions. They take personal responsibility. They don't make excuses, and they don't blame other people. This really is a sort of superpower that we have as men. It's something that is unique to us, this drive that we have, this inner drive that we want more. We want to have an impact on the world. We want to live in a way that is meaningful, not just to us, but to those around us as well. And having this chip on your shoulder to be angry in a positive way, to prove ourselves wrong, to prove others wrong, it's really like I said, it's almost supernatural. It gives you an energy. It helps you to jump out of bed almost excited to attack the day, because you know you're working on something. You're working to improve yourself. You have goals. You see positive things that are coming in your future that you are looking forward to realizing in your life. And as you go through your life with this positive chip on your shoulder and you make improvements, the people around you, they get uncomfortable. Whenever those who are living in mediocrity see somebody who's not content with that and they're striving to do better, they're working to improve themselves, it kind of strikes their conscience a little bit. They realize that they should be doing more as well. And most men who are stuck with that negative chip on their shoulder, who want to attack and bring other people down instead of do what needs to be done in their own life, what they're going to do is try to bring you down as well. This can be family members, friends, coworkers, wherever. Wherever people see, other people see the improvement you're making and they get uncomfortable, they're going to try to plant those seeds of doubt in your head. And when you have the right chip on your shoulder, that doubt doesn't seep in and affect you at all. In fact, it just gives you more energy. You hear what they're saying, and you have this almost defiant attitude where you're like, okay, you think I can't do something? You think I can't do what I'm trying to do with my life? And you think I can't be what I want to be? I'll show you. You know, I'll show you that I can be exactly what I say I can be and do what I want to do and achieve what I want to achieve. So it's that chip on your shoulder. You're not meaning it in a destructive way toward other people. You're meaning it to improve yourself, to give yourself energy, to give yourself ambition, to continue moving forward. There's nothing wrong with giving yourself a challenge to prove other people wrong. They've when they naysay and they hate on you and they tell you you can't do something, they're challenging you. And as a man, that sparks a fire in us. You know, we that's part of our masculinity. We get that fire that burns in us that wants to show everyone around us that we're more than they think we are, that we're capable of more than they think we're capable of. And that's great. Competition is an awesome and wonderful thing in that regard. Now, this also works on your own self-doubt as well. You know, I wish that men were immune to self-doubt, to doubting themselves, but we're not, especially when we're doing hard things, when we're challenging ourselves to be better, we're challenging ourselves to do something that we haven't done before, or that maybe previously we would have thought we couldn't do. And as we move forward with whatever it is we're trying to achieve, we're moving toward our goals, obstacles, adversity, it's inevitable. Things come along that are going to really challenge us to dig deep and to push forward, to have that self-confidence, to not let it get us down. And that's very challenging at times, but just like when other people are telling us what we can't do and we start to have that lingering nagging doubt that might get into our heads, and we tell it to be gone, right? We say we're not going to accept this. We're more than this. We can do exactly the things that these people are saying that I can't do. And the same thing needs to happen with yourself. When doubt starts to creep in, when you run into a little bit of trouble, instead of letting that drag you down to sap your energy, let it give you more energy. Let it drive you to push forward even harder to get past that challenge and continue pressing forward toward whatever goal it is you're working toward. I mean, nobody wants these challenges as they're happening. But if you really think about it, is achieving some kind of goal really that valuable if it came easy, if there were no challenges? I don't think so. I mean, I think the challenges and the obstacles that we have to overcome, that's what makes victory so sweet when we get to finally taste it at the end. So embrace those challenges, embrace the obstacles. Don't let them start to have your mind overwhelmed with self-doubt because you start seeing these hurdles come your way. Look at them as opportunities. Don't look at them as challenges. They're opportunities to continue to grow, to learn something you didn't know before, to make a connection with somebody that you didn't have a connection with previously. In every challenge, there's immense opportunity, and you can either choose to let it beat you down and to make you give up, or you can use it to your advantage. And so I suggest that you use it to your advantage. And having that positive chip on your shoulder allows you to do that. And when you do get past that, it just gives you that much more self-confidence as you go forward and you continue to challenge yourself and you continue to do difficult things because you've looked something in the eyes. You've looked challenges. You faced them face to face. You've looked them in the eyes and you beat them. You move forward. You saw that when faced with adversity, you can overcome. It doesn't have to defeat you. You can be the victor. And so that just gives you that much more confidence as you continue to progress, you continue to work towards your goal, or maybe you achieved your goal and you set a new, more challenging goal. Now you have confidence to know that when the going gets tough, you can make it through and that the day will be brighter on the other side. And always remember that you can choose how you react to things. You get to choose. When somebody says you can't do something, when somebody tries to bring you down, when somebody who's content in their mediocrity tries to get you to be content with yours, you can choose how to react to that. You don't have to listen to them. You don't have to give any credence to what they're saying. You don't have to let it bring you down. You can choose to take that in, internalize it, and let it motivate you. Or you can choose to believe what they're saying and continue in whatever mediocre existence you might have in some regard, and never be satisfied, remain where you are year after year, and never pursue your purpose or your passions. The choice should be clear. You know, there are a lot of things outside of your control, and what people are going to tell you and say to you and try to convince you of, that's one of them. That's outside of your control. But what's inside of your control is how you respond to that. And how you respond to that is everything. And that positive chip on your shoulder gives you that drive to respond in a positive way. You don't hate on that person for telling you that you can't do something. You seek to prove to yourself that you absolutely can. If you look at President Donald Trump, do you think as he was going through the process of trying to become the president of the United States, that as people were telling him that he couldn't do things, that he wouldn't win, that he had no shot, do you think he listened to that? No, he didn't listen to it. He took that in. That was fuel for his fire. He used that to energize him. And if you look at his campaign, and I'm not trying to use this podcast here to promote Donald Trump by any means, but if you look at his campaign, the guy was the most energetic presidential candidate that I've seen in my 35 years of life here. I mean, that came from somewhere. I mean, the guy's 70 years old. That came from somewhere. That drive, that energy came from somewhere. And I believe it was the chip on his shoulder that he has. He has a chip on his shoulder for success. He wants to prove other people wrong. He wants to prove to himself that he can do things. And when you listen to the guy talk, you can see that all of the challenges and things that he's dealt with in his business life up to this point have prepared him for exactly that. Nothing ever dampened his spirits. He never doubted himself. He had confidence because he had faced challenges and had gotten over them before. And how much greater a feeling do you think it was for Donald Trump as he's standing on that stage election night, knowing that he won, that he was president of the greatest country on earth, after so many people had stood there and pontificated that there was absolutely no way that he would ever be president. There was no way he would ever be the Republican nominee. There was no way he would win a primary in a single state. You know, all of these people that doubted him, that hated on what he was trying to accomplish, they just made his victory that much sweeter. And that's the same thing for us. That's the kind of energy that we need to take from the doubts that we have maybe about ourselves, or that other people place in our heads, that when we do finally succeed, it's going to make us feel that much better. It's going to make achieving that goal that much sweeter. So have a chip on your shoulder. Be pissed off for success. Set out to prove other people wrong. Show them that you can do everything they say that you can't do. Show yourself that you can be more than you think you can be. Show yourself that you have potential to be more than you realize, that there are things that you can achieve and an impact that you can have on the world as a masculine man that maybe would have been thought in your mind to be impossible in the past or even today. You know, you look at something you want to achieve and it just seems so far removed from where you are now. But by having that chip on your shoulder and striving to be more and continuing to overcome different challenges and reaching goals that you set for yourself, it just continues to compound that self-confidence that you have, that you can do more, that you can achieve more. And, you know, it's just like when a man finally makes it to the top of a mountain, climbing it again doesn't really quite seem that intimidating anymore. And so he must find a new, higher, taller, more formidable mountain that he seeks to challenge himself to make it to the top of. And it's the same way in a man's life. As you set goals and you reach them and you challenge yourself and you do things that you didn't think you could do before, it just continues to build. You build your skill set, you build your confidence, and before long, you're doing things that you never would have dreamed were possible for you. But it all starts with having that first motivation to succeed and having that chip on your shoulder that allows you to plow through, to continue to gain energy and build fuel off of the things that happen as you pursue a better life, as you pursue more for yourself, as you go through challenges and people plant doubts in your head and you have your own self-doubts, and you take that and you turn it into energy, almost a limitless supernatural energy that you can use to continue to progress as a man. You have to resist that temptation to point that chip outward, though. You don't point it outward. Don't start looking at what everybody else has that you don't, what everybody else does that you don't do, what everybody might be in your head. You're thinking they're keeping you from things or keeping you down. Don't do that. That's toxic. That is of no value to you. It will only serve to keep you in whatever current state you're in. It will not allow you to progress. And there's no value in it. You need to point that chip inward. Look at what you need to do in order to prove to yourself and to others that you can achieve whatever it is you set your mind to, because you can. Focus on the things that you have control over. Focus on your thoughts, the things that you're reading, the things that you're researching, the things that you're doing, and make sure that they're aligned with where you want to take your life. The things that are outside of your control are inconsequential. They're meaningless. You can't do anything about them anyway. Focus on what is inside of your control, and great things will eventually come for you. All right, that's it for today's podcast. So again, have a chip on your shoulder. Don't worry about the things outside of your control. Take what other people say about what you can't do. Use it for fuel. Focus on the things that are inside of your control. Align your actions, align your thoughts around what you want to achieve as a man and the impact you want to have on the world. So that's it for today. Again, this is Craig James from MasculinityByDesign.com, on Twitter @MasculineDesign. Until next time, I'm out.